Katoliko to the bone. Bago ako mag-shorts. So, mag-umuwi po ako ng Maynila, ito po ang nangyayari. Episodes from Bawal number 15, Manila, Hedonia. Unang araw ko sa lungsod, umuwi ako sa kawawala. Lumilihis ako sa daan ng mga dating kaibigan at kaibigan at nagpapakasasa, nagpapakasaba, nagpapakasuga pa sa sarap. Gumigising at nahihimbing lulan ng pagkalasing. Usok na parang ulap na pumapalibot sa matang umaandap-andap. Di na mawari kailan nagsimula ang ngayon, sa natapos ang kanina at sa nagsimula ang bukas. Nagpapakabingi. Nagpapakabulag, nagtakpiniringan ng puso at lumulukso-lukso sa apoy at kumunoy, sabay-sabay nagarapat na susugatan. Pero tawa lang at tawa sa sakit at sa ilo, inoroman ka watak-watak ng sentido, halimaw sa pagkabuang tuguang bumubungis-ngis, basag ulong nagahalakakan habang parang nahulog na pinggan ang kabuluhan, naging bubog na lamang.
Bakit?
At wala ding nahita, kundi isang sunog na alaala. Bitak-bitak na pagsinta, ubos-upos na pag-asa. Wala ding mabaon, pabalik sa aking isla, kundi pagsisisit, pagkaminaw sa aking matumal at payapang luklukan sa gitna ng dagat, kung saan ang mundo'y salubong. At ang malinaw na hangarin ng pagsintay na balisa. You're so hot, blind men can spot you from miles away, and the source of lepers vanish when your hair touches their wounds. You're so hot. Other women grow beards whenever you pass by, and lovely tresses of their hair that cover the ground, protect your delicate feet from the dirt. You're so hot, you make me shit my pants in fear and admiration with every word you speak. You're so hot. Japanese printmakers dreamed you into existence centuries ago as forlorn women weeping over bridges, as ghosts searching for their lovers in the velvet gloom of twilight, as red umbrellas made of rice paper and bamboo flying over the waves of tempestuous water-colored seas. Chagall saw you riding a horse with a violin in his mouth. Van Gogh imagined you in every sunflower he painted, in the setting sun of Marseille, in that starry, starry night that drove him into joyful madness. When he could no longer bear the immeasurable burden of a muse he could not see but could not touch, of a muse whose voice he could hear in the dark corners of his claustrophobia. He cut off his ear, that crazy motherfucker, so that he wouldn't hear you whispering in his sleep. You're so... I will have to surgically remove this crystalline brain of Noam Chomsky, place it in my own skull, and invent a new language to describe this ineffable quality of your hotness. But it will still not be enough because you make the word hot sound like like a Tibetan mantra chanted by Buddhist monks who praise a celestial lotus whose inner chamber contains only your face and your voice. You're so hot. I wish I could take dissonant eggshells of your personality and form them into something that resembles a homage. But you have so many faces, and they quiver in my palm like the shards of a broken church window, a puzzle as deep and as enduring as a constellation blazing into life or the origins of bacteria on a desert planet. And each time I see you, I am like God. I am like God standing before the primordial sea, unable to shape it into a form I